In the wake of the budget, if we move away from that issue specifically, but it's still relevant because I wonder how you've seen the budget reaction and debate since then, because to me it seems like ministers have had different priorities right now, and including on this issue.
It looks like a shambles. Because in the weeks after the budget, what you want to be talking about is the budget, and the centrepiece of the budget, it appears to me, was $300 that the government wanted to give out, plus the tax cuts. There's plenty to talk about in that, the good things that people are getting out of the budget. And yet we have ministers freelancing on tax policy and clearly displeasing the Treasurer on that front. We have backbenchers talking about the state of Palestine. And I think the real issue here at the moment, and the thing I hear of bureaucracy, is there's no strength in the centre. There's nothing coming from the Prime Minister's office. There is no one dragging people into line to try and keep them on track. And I think that's a real issue for this government, because it appears to me at the moment that ministers are basically pushing their own bandwagons. There's no central message coming out of the Labor Party. And in the end, disunity is death. Now, I'm not saying that's necessarily going to be the case. At the next election, the coalition comes from a very long way back, but they could find themselves falling into minority government if this shambles continues.
The migrant detainee issue, I wonder where this sits in the mind of voters. It does appear from all surveys, cost of living remains 1, 2 and 3 as the biggest issues. But either way, it's not a... not an easy time for Andrew Giles in the parliament.
And there's a large target drawn around him, and I wouldn't worry too much if I was him about the baying of the opposition. They'll always call for a minister's scalp. I'd worry about the silence of his colleagues. And when you saw him stand in parliament yesterday to defend himself, that was the thing that shouted loudest to me. You can always tell when a minister is in trouble, when the colleagues fall silent. They're not supporting him in what he has to say. He is a man alone at the moment. And when you're in government, there's an old saying, you know, the opposition is in front of you, your enemies are behind you. The only people who can benefit are some of his colleagues who might be looking at his job and wanting it and thinking that there might be a reshuffle by about mid-year. So if I was Andrew Giles, I'd be looking behind me rather than in front of me for where the trouble might lie.
And on the energy front, we had those reports last week. We touched on it in the analysis of nuclear versus renewables, and Chris Bowen having a bit of a field day yesterday, targeting, among others, Barnaby Joyce with his reference to the CSIRO.
Yeah, and I'll take Chris Bowen seriously when Chris Bowen delivers $275 based on when he came to government, which was a couple of years ago, a cut in electricity prices, which are going up. We've had some small relief by way of cuts to retail prices. But he said the trajectory in the long run would be down because we'd get more renewable energy and it would be cheaper. And again, I don't quite understand the hysteria that the Labor Party has about nuclear energy. If no one's ever going to back it, no one's ever going to build it, then lift the ban and have the debate. But here's one thing I'll tell you about nuclear energy. First and foremost, it is that, well, let's take GenCos on its numbers, $17 billion. At the upper end of the limit, it said, what's Snowy Hydro costing? It's gone from $2 to $6 to $12 billion. How long has it taken? That's one project, which is a battery project. It doesn't generate electricity. It moves the time at which you deliver electricity. The other thing about nuclear energy is, if you look at land mass, it needs 370 times less land mass than equivalent amount of wind energy. Those factors are going to come into consideration as we build out Chris Bowen's dream to have nothing essentially but renewables running the grid. Look at what the landscape will look like come 10, 20, 30 years' time.